And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. If the Son set you free, you shall be free indeed. Can you say an amen there? Amen. I welcome you all who are here tonight. It's a privilege that we can be here and share God's word together. And to those of you who are watching us through the live streaming in your homes, wherever you may find yourself around the world, we welcome you to this program that is happening live here in Lagos Satellite Town, and it is dubbed The Untold Truth. And it's a prophecy seminar, technically sandwiched with some evangelistic series. I want to make to you five promises. Promise number one is the Bible shall be the bedrock of our study. And the reason is the Bible means what it says and says what it means. Promise number two is you shall be enlightened irrespective of who you are. Promise number three is you will be challenged to make apparently the most important decision of your life. And promise number four is those who love the Lord, they shall be baptized. And promise number five, your life will never be the same. As a means of recap, yesterday we dealt with our opening topic, which was the untold truth about the written truth. The untold truth about the written truth. And yesterday we looked at the Bible as God's inspired word. We saw it in its context. The Bible has given very unequivocal statement that it is an authoritative book. It is a nameless book. It is a revealed book. It is a respected book. It is a timeless book. The Bible says it is a life transforming book. In fact, it is not just that, also it is inspired. And throughout the centuries, men and women have attempted to destroy God's infallible word, but the Bible's truth is still matching all. But the sad news we noticed yesterday is that many people don't have time to read the Bible. So yesterday I gave an assignment that we should read a chapter. Who can remember the chapter I asked that we should read? Genesis chapter 1. How many people read it? How many people read it? Can you just show your hands? Can we just show your hands? All right. I've seen that is exactly the point, that we have time for every other thing. But the Bible, to those of you joining us home, less than 10% of our audience here have been able to do the assignment. And that is an F. So tonight, I will give another assignment. We are reading Matthew chapter 1. Matthew chapter 1. And tomorrow we would like to see how many persons have really dealt with that assignment. Ladies and gentlemen, for the sake of time, our topic tonight is the untold truth about, it ought to be the truth. The untold truth about the truth. You see, I started yesterday with this statement. In our world today, the fear of rejection, which is deadly than rejection itself, has made speaking the truth an undesirable virtue. No one wants to tell the truth anymore. Why? We are in an age of riskless and a comfort zone mindset. Everyone wants to be free. Everyone wants to be happy. Everyone wants to be in comfort. And this has made people to speak half truth. They tell a truth and they buttress it with a lie, and they feel they are telling the truth. In other instances, people economize truth. So if you see half truth, if you see economized truth, it has become the new standard for truth. In politics, half truth is churned out to be truth. In economics, half truth is churned out to be truth. Ladies and gentlemen, this is where the world has reached currently. However, we are talking about the untold truth. So what is it? The untold truth is the truth that is uncommon. It is a truth that is unbending. It is a truth that is untwisting. It is a truth that is unpopular. It It is the truth. In fact, if it is spoken well, it is seen as if it is divisive. It divides people. They are told truth. Ladies and gentlemen, this kind of truth, when it is spoken, this untold truth, it will shake the speakers. It will shake the hearers from their comfort or their ease habits. Thereby, when you listen to the untold truth, it will make you to think the unthinkable. It will make you to do the undoable. It will make you to speak the unspeakable. As a matter of fact, any Nigerian, any African, anyone listening whatsoever, from wherever you are listening from, if you desire a world of truth, the next 12 days, the same time, the same place, you got to join us, because what you'll be listening to, it will challenge you, it will dare you, it will make you very uncomfortable, but that is what it ought to be. The untold truth. It has consequences. There are ripple effects. There are punishment for speaking and for following the untold truth. Because of the consequences of the untold truth, it has birthed many common and comfortable truth speakers. Some people, quite frankly, are thinking they are telling the truth. But because they are saying half truth and economized truth, which doesn't have any ripple effect, they are comfortable. I call such truth speakers and such truth seekers part-time apostles of truth. Untold truth will never regard your degrees. So during these 2 weeks, your degree is irrelevant to the subject matter. Your bad degree is irrelevant to the subject matter. Your wealth, your personality. In fact, this man, I love the way he put it, George Orwell. He says, in a time of universal deceit, deceit everywhere, telling the truth becomes a revolutionary act. And I want to set the tone. If you are a Christian, if you are a human being, if you are a Muslim, if you are a Buddhist, if you are an atheist, whatsoever belief you have, during this 2 weeks gospel campaign or Bible lecture series, Doubt the Untold Truth, you are going to see what we will share to be very revolutionary. It is not. The only reason why it will look so is because we are in a time of universal deceit. The untold truth about the truth. What we are talking from a prophetic perspective. So those of you who are joining us, and those of you joining us today, we said yesterday that history is prophecy fulfilled. And prophecy is history in advance. So, before history happens, prophecy predates history. It is an antecedent to history. And history is when prophecy comes to fulfillment. Yesterday we looked at it this way. That our world is in crisis. Yesterday we said that we are going through a lot of challenges beyond human proportion. So we said yesterday that God has apportioned blessing to those who read, to those who read, those who hear, and those who do the biddings of God's own word. I will need a help here. Ladies and gentlemen, they are told truth. The book of Revelation is a book from heaven. Our focus is the book of Revelation. It's not a book from any man. It's a book from heaven. How do I know? I want to set the tone. It says it's the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show
his angel to his servant John. Did you notice that? Him, his, he, his, he. The book Understanding is about Jesus Christ. The Old Testament and the Gospel, they portray Jesus, especially the Gospel, they portray Jesus in a certain light. But the book of Revelation is the colored picture of the personality of Jesus. It depicts who actually Jesus is. So this study is premise. This night I want to an envelope. We want to take off. We want to rediscover who this Jesus is. And he said, this book is to be born or to be witness to the word of God. And it is the testimony to all that he saw. John is to write what he saw. And is to bear testimony of who this Jesus is. By this extension, if you go to Revelation 22 verse 16, the Bible says, I, Jesus, I have sent my angel to testify unto these things in the churches. On a lighter note, the book of Revelation is meant for church members. I am the roots and the offspring of David and the bright morning star. I will get there to do an analysis on that. Just for the sake of the record, point number one, the book Understanding This Night, or of which we may
God is great.